What's up, guys? Swaggy, you're back, and today we're talking about the Seahawks drafting Anthony Richardson with the fifth pick in the draft. This is honestly a one in, do I say a million chance? I mean, that might be a stretch, but this is a very long shot. The Seahawks having the fifth pick in the draft to begin with, and then a 6'4", 244-pound man that runs a 4.4 and has a 40-inch vertical, right? A nearly 11-foot broad jump. But it's not just his athleticism. That's what the media will tell you. Be honest, man. You guys probably think that Richardson is just some athletic freak that can't throw a football, that can't read a defense, and has bad footwork. And partially, you're correct. But also, if you look at multiple scouts, right? Again, multiple NFL scouts have come out and said that Richardson's interview not only was the best of the quarterbacks, but it blew them away. And the reason why I decided to make this video is because of two reasons. For one, I like Anthony Richardson. And for two, I like the Seahawks. Well, Richardson, he spoke to Pete Carroll, and here's how their interaction went, and I'm going to quote Richardson on that. So, quote, he had this big smile on his face. We shook hands, and something about it was just different. You only see these guys on TV, and now I'm in their presence, and they're right there talking to me, and they're interested in me. That makes you feel good, end quote. So Richardson and Carroll, they had a good interaction. It's pretty clear that Geno Smith was signed for next season, because he's getting all this guaranteed money. He's getting $54 million in the first year, and then there's no guaranteed money the next two. So they can easily move on from Geno if they want. Will they do that? I don't know. I'm not a psychic. But what I do know is that Geno is not the future of this team. He's, you know, what is he, 32 years old, and he had a good season. He's backed up Russ for the past three, but he's not a long-term quarterback, right? That's why you go out there and you take full advantage of having the fifth pick via Denver, and you bring in your future guy. And to me, I'm not interested in Bryce Young. And I'm saying this as a Colts fan. I don't want Bryce Young because he's 5'10", 5'11 at the most. I think he came in at 5'10 something at the combine, under 200 pounds. Now, is Bryce Young a better quarterback than Anthony Richardson? Oh, yeah. Without a doubt, it's not even debatable. Bryce Young's accuracy and just intangibles, and he has some of the best footwork I've seen in my life. But again, he's 5'10", under 200 pounds. That's not going to translate to the NFL. And people will say that it will, but you know, name one guy in the history of the NFL that lasted that was that size. It doesn't happen. Richardson, he's flying out draft boards. It's not necessarily because of his athleticism. We know that, you know, he had over 100 carries at Florida. We know what he brings in terms of running the football and athleticism. But it's just his hard work ethic, his willingness to do whatever it takes. And he can come in, sit behind a Seahawks team that is just incredibly loaded with talent, behind Geno Smith, who is as accurate as it gets. I mean, you talk about throwing a perfect spiral. Geno Smith's your guy. Why do you think he led the league in completion? Sure, a lot of it's the system, but you know, Geno Smith is an incredible football player. That's why he got over $100 million. So you go out there, you draft Anthony Richardson, you put him behind Geno, and you have your future guy, but also right now you have a quarterback who is good enough to get you to a Super Bowl. So let me know your guys' thoughts on that, man. I know it was a lot to take in just a couple of minutes, but you know, personally, the more I think about this, the more I like it. I mean, if you look at Richardson, you'll see that he was 500 as a starter. He threw 17 touchdowns, 9 interceptions, completed, if you round up, 54% of his passes. He doesn't look the great. You know, as a quarterback, he doesn't look the greatest. But this is a gamble. It's a risk. And if you're going to risk, again, a top five pick, it's not like this is the 27th pick in the draft. This is a top five pick. If you're going to do that, use it on a 21-year-old who, again, we've never seen an athlete like this at the quarterback position. We haven't seen many athletes like this in general. 6'4", 244 with these types of, you know, combine, you know, and measurements. I mean, it's honestly just ridiculous. If you were to make a created player, you would try to make Anthony Richardson. In Madden, you can't even do that. Again, you can't make a 6'4" man that runs like RG3 and that can throw outside the numbers, that can throw the deep ball. And by the way, doing it with poor footwork, like horrible footwork, that's Anthony Richardson's biggest issue. It's not reading a defense. He can read a defense. And we've seen that at Florida. They've thrown different coverages at him. And sometimes, yeah, like, you know, he got mixed up and he didn't know what to do. But a lot of the times, he knew exactly what they were going to do and he put the ball in the right place. So this is a project. This is not a year one quarterback. This is not Lamar Jackson. Don't get it twisted. Anthony Richardson is not Lamar Jackson. He's not even close as a passer. Athleticism is a different story. I mean, like, again, but yeah, let me know your guys' thoughts on this. And the reason why I try to get to 1,000. So if you guys want the link, go in the description. It will be there. If you guys want to talk Seahawks to me for absolutely no cost, join the Discord. Every single day I'm active in that. So that's why you draft Richardson at 5, because the Seahawks aren't going to have the 5th pick again anytime soon. It's just not going to happen. Pete Carroll, he gets these guys to the playoffs every single year. They're always competitive. They're not going to have a top 5 pick. So you might as well take advantage of it and get your guy for the future. And then, you know, you let potentially your quarterback right now in Geno Smith go to a different team, get a bigger contract or something like that. Again, it's incredibly confusing because Geno just signed the contract, and I know everyone's not even thinking about the future, but it is something that's come up. And I wouldn't have made this video if I didn't read the report about, you know, Anthony Richardson and Pete Carroll and how their interaction went. I mean, it was pretty interesting. I mean, I'll give you guys a quote from Richardson himself. So he had this big smile on his face. We shook hands, and something about it was just different. You only see these guys on TV, and now I'm in their presence, and they're right there talking to me, and they're interested in me. That makes you feel good. End quote. So you guys can see, Richardson, the Seahawks, it couldn't be a better fit. But if you're a Seattle fan, you might not want this. You might be saying, hey, look, you know, we won 9 games. We beat the 49ers if we had a better defense. Let's use that pick on defense. Let's use even the 20th pick on defense. Try to build up the offensive line. Get another receiver next to Lockett and Metcalf. And Jamal Adams is coming back. Bring in Bobby Wagner, who still is that dude. And boom, we're Super Bowl contenders. Why are we thinking about a quarterback for the future? Again, there's really no wrong answer. I'm just letting you guys know, if you go to ESPN, if you start listening to analysts, which I normally never do that, but this morning before I made the video, I was like, let me go and see how they feel. And a lot of people, they don't understand that Anthony Richardson's not a bad quarterback. They're going to look at the numbers and say, oh my God, he completed 54% of his passes. He went 6-6 as the starter on a pretty good team. He threw 9 interceptions and 17 touchdowns. Yeah, that's true. But when he goes to the next level, he already has things that you can't teach. I mean, he's an incredible athlete. He has a deep ball. He can throw outside the numbers. The coaching staff, they're going to have time to work with him. I'm not saying that you're going to bring him in and start him over Geno. That's not the point. You're going to be putting him behind Geno for the next 1, 2, or even 3 seasons, letting him learn the league, learn the speed of the game, and build around him, right? You've got Kenneth Walker. You've got DK Metcalf for the future. You've got Noah Fant, as long as he comes back. I believe he's a free agent next season. You've got a young offensive line with, of course, Cross and Lucas. You guys have a pretty good left guard. So that's the point of the video, man, is that Seattle, they're in a spot right now to where they can take full advantage of getting a quarterback for the future. Or they can trade back, right? They can get more picks. They can draft the best defensive player at 5. Maybe Jalen Carter falls there. Probably not, but maybe, you never know, right? At the end of the day, the Seahawks, they have options. That's exactly where you want to be. They can go 3 different routes here. Whatever one they do, I wouldn't even hate it. Legitimately, they trade back and get more picks. It just means more talent on the roster, more depth, which goes a long way. You need depth to win a Super Bowl, right? If they want to take the best guy at 5, Miles Murphy, maybe? I don't know. Who else is going to be there at that range? I don't think the Seahawks will take a corner there, so maybe they go Tyree Wilson. I don't think personally, though, the Seahawks need any more edge rushers. I think they need a guy up front. And I think that they need a little bit of help in the secondary. I mean, they've got Kobe Bryant. They've got Tariq Woolen. They've got Ryan Neal, assuming he comes back in free agency. And, you know, Adams is coming back. And they still have Quandre Diggs, who might not be a Pro Bowl level player anymore, but he's still a damn good one. Yeah, if you guys are looking for Seahawks news, you're in the right place. I'll be posting pretty much daily. Love what you guys have going on. I love making these videos. And yeah, it's going to be a blast, man. Peace.